Here, I'm going to show you guys how to find the domain and the range of this rational function. And let me tell you, this right here can be really tricky, so pay close attention. First off, for the domain, remember, you always look at the bottom and then set it not equal to 0. So we have the 4x minus 12. Go ahead and just put 4x minus 12, and we do not want this to be equal to 0. And then work this out. Put the 12 here, so we get 4x is not equal to 0. 4x is not equal to 12, and then divide both sides by 4, x cannot be equal to 3. And that's the restriction, so we'll just write the domain is that we go from negative infinity to 3, but not including the 3, by union, the other part is 3 to infinity. This is it, done deal. Now for the range, this right here is usually harder, but for this one, yeah, it's also tricky too. Notice, on the top and bottom, we can actually factor and cancel things out. On the top, we factor this out, we get x minus 3 times x plus 1. On the bottom, we can factor out 4, and that will give us 4 times x minus 3. And this and that can cancel, so we are just going to get x plus 1 over 4. In fact, this is just a line, right? Because we can look at this as 1 over 4x plus 1 over 4. However, this function is not really just a line, because when we cancel the x minus 3 on the top and bottom, we have to denote that x cannot be equal to 3. When we graph this line, in fact, we have to put this into consideration as well. So let me show you. Okay, so let's review how we can graph the line. We start with the y-intercept, which is 1 over 4. Let's say it's right here, all right? And then the slope is 1 over 4. That means we go up one time, and then you go to the right 4 times. It doesn't really matter how the graph looks like, because you know you will just have a line like this. Just give a quick sketch, and then of course, you know the line will keep on going down forever and keep going up forever. Now, here's the deal. X cannot be equal to 3. We will also have to put that into consideration on the graph. So let's say 3 is right here, because earlier it was up 1 to the right 4 times, yeah? Now, we are going to go up and then get rid of that point on the graph. So we will have an open circle here. And here is the key. We have to find out the y value of this open circle, because that's the y value that's missing. And y can be anything else except for that. So how can we do that? Well, in this case, that's the concept of the limit. We are going to study the behavior of the function around 3. What we can do is actually just go ahead and put the 3, not to the original though, because otherwise we will get 0 over 0. Go ahead and just put it here. So if you have this right here, 1 over 4 times 3, and then plus 1 over 4, we can work this out. This right here is just going to be 3 over 4 plus 1 over 4, and that will just give us 4 over 4, which is 1. So, in fact, when x is equal to 3, the y value here, it will be 1. And that's actually the missing y value. And when you have the picture, you know, to find the domain, it's so much better, you know, have a picture first. Right here, I can tell you, the range will just go into b. We go from negative infinity, right, because y can go all the way down up to 1, right? 1 is missing. So stop like this, and then union, we go from 1 to infinity. All right? That's it. And perhaps I will tell you guys this right here. There's a open circle or hole at 3, 1. And that's why 3 is not in the domain, and likewise 1 is also not in the range. That's it.